For me, when it comes to media impact on Black History Month, or really just our experience, I wish it weren't an exploitation of the opportunity to discuss Black history. But if whoever's getting a dollar, I'm not here to, you know, necessarily stop you, especially if those are Black dollars. But I wish we could do better. I wish it was socialized like the Super Bowl. The Super Bowl is one Sunday out of the year, and it's socialized every day of the year. Platforms like TheGrio, or platforms like Because of Them We Can, you know, make it their business to articulate their mission is driven in diversifying content in a way that explores all cultures, especially people of color. So I appreciate and I like that it's trending positively, but I don't want it to just be a trend. So that my issue with media is their accountability to be authentic with themselves, what they say they're going to do, and how we all go about doing it.
Oh yeah, I would definitely say that in the past 5 to 10 years, there has been an increase in coverage, both on my social media and in media at large, and like big news networks and whatnot. And part of me accredits that to what happened in Ferguson years ago with the killing of Michael Brown and the energy that that created. So during Black History Month now, I definitely see a surge in Black stories being told. And it finally reaching out to non-Black people. And a lot of times they're like putting their 2 cents in, which is sometimes great and sometimes catastrophic. But I see a surge in it during Black History Month and also throughout the year.
I just hate that it requires something so catastrophic to happen. Mm-hmm. Essentially, the time before that would have been the murder of Emmett Till, which gave the same energy, right? And so we fast forward to Ferguson, and we have that same energy, but it's like, well, what will it take? What does it take? And all of these moments, I think, humanize this, right? Because when it boils down, we're all human, but why does it take those types of scenarios to make this a normalcy for us to have these conversations when Black and brown people are here every day and they're in, you know, every part of every human experience.
Going forward with Black History Month, what I would like to see in addition to what's already happening is for people who look like me, white people all over the United States and wherever else, to allow themselves to practice taking a step back and letting Black people tell their stories about their lived experiences in the country so that they can kind of little brother their big brother. White people could take a step back and really just honestly let that happen and reflect on where they're at during that time. How does it feel for Black people to be like doing things that Black people do? And how does it feel to not be entitled to that time? How does it feel to just sit and listen and learn and not have the spotlight be on us?
For me, you know, it's a lot different because for me, Black History Month honestly just isn't enough. I would like to see Black history and Black people of color in general, just celebrated. Now I'm gonna be specific. Black people specifically incorporated and celebrated in a way 365 days of the year, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so that we begin normalizing that conversation. Mm-hmm. I think isolating Black history to the shortest month of the year is just a huge disservice. It's a slap in the face. It's honestly the handout. For me, it's saying you should be appreciative of this, whereas no, I don't. I would rather not even see a Black History Month. I just would like to normalize the idea of celebrating all people all the time for their accomplishments, where they are, in their acknowledgement, no matter who you are. As a culture, as a people, we can just be more accountable of educating our children at home, as well as holding our teachers accountable of sharing that knowledge and maybe sharing their own experiences. And to your point, also knowing what we don't know. Mm-hmm. You don't have to speak on everything because it's a topic. It's okay to not be a part of the trend. And so for me, I would rather see Black history start to blossom in that vein. I think we're living in a beautiful time where everything is changing, the way we communicate with one another, the kind of way, the way we work, the way we live. And I think we don't have to subscribe to what was given to us, because our parents and our grandparents, they're not here to kind of dictate what this has to look like for our children.